Threema is the current superhero of messenger services and has the hearts of data protectionists racing. But is all that glitters really gold? After all, Threema was only programmed by a single developer. Is that trustworthy? Who knows? We take a look under the hood of the top messenger and put the privacy by design credo through its pace. So, let's go! Welcome to Ask a Data Protection Officer, this time with the exciting analysis of the messenger Threema. And this will be completely new territory for some of you. Starting with the name, Threema sounds like theme, but with too many typos? Yes, but it's actually the most secure messenger currently available. Even my favorite Signal can't quite keep up. But first things first. We want to check the current top messengers for their security, taking technology, law, and business into account. That's why I've come up with some points to make this check possible and help you to classify the results correctly. After all, the point is that you can make an informed and voluntary decision. Because I know that most of us can't do much with long prefaces, here are the final results for Threema right away for ya. Threema offers the highest possible privacy and completely anonymizes its users, is based on best-in-class open-source encryption and is run by an ISO 27100 certified Swiss company on its own servers exclusively. So let's take a look at the criteria that led to the super rating in Threema's case. On the technical side, we have the questions. First, is there end-to-end encryption and if so, is it secure? Second, is metadata collected and if so, how is it anonymized and pseudonymized? Third, is the source code independently verifiable and independently validated? On the legal side, we have first, are the terms of use in compliance with the GDPR? Second, is the privacy policy easily understandable, transparent and precise? Third, can users fully exercise their rights and is the process easily accessible? Fourth, where is the provider located and which national laws are in effect? And on the business side, we conclude with, first, what is the provider's business model? Second, what is the asset value and ownership? And third, what aspirations for the future are known? Once again, a whole lot of sweet talk to work through, so I say get comfortable and look forward to this messenger check. When it comes to technology, Threema is the very clear frontrunner among messengers. Threema offers all the common and well-known functions to private and group chats, audio and video calls, address books, and so on and so forth. With Threema Work, the app even expands into the mobile device management solution for businesses and teams. Threema is based on the open-source asymmetric encryption NACI, which was developed by Daniel Bernstein and Tanja Lange and enjoys an excellent reputation among cryptographers. Asymmetric means that all messages between sender and recipient can only be encrypted or decrypted using a coordinated pair of a private and public key. The recipient always receives only the public key. This makes it virtually impossible for third parties to change or circumvent the encryption. Threema is operated with an ID instead of an email address or phone number. There is also a three-stage verification process to confirm the security of a contact. Here a distinction is made between external messages without a contact in the address book, external messages with a contact in the address book, and QR code verified communications, which also leads to another feature, namely the verification of a contact via QR code scan. Of course, this requires both people to be in the same place to show as well as scan the QR code. With Threema, really everything is encrypted. Are the golden days gone when NSA, BND and KGB could tap privacy via these lines? Yes. Not only does Threema not store any data in unencrypted form, right down to the device groups during synchronization processes. No, even the contents of the messages are immediately deleted from the server after delivery to the recipient. Furthermore, Threema is the only messenger that can currently be used without providing any personal data. email address or phone number are only collected when using the contact search. Again, the encryption is excellent as the data on your device is converted into content sums, so-called hash values. These are then encrypted and transmitted to the server, which decrypts the data and compares them to the hash values of known users. After the comparison, the data is removed again from the server. Even the participants of the group chats are never known to the Threema server. Instead, all messages are delivered to the users individually as private messages. Threema only displays them as groups for convenience. But that's not all. Threema does not collect any data about the app's usage time and cycles, not even the access times or the sending and receiving times of messages are stored centrally. Here, almost everything that can be kept secret is really kept secret. Small fun fact on the side though, even the Threema website does not use cookies or tracking of analytics software. As mentioned earlier, Threema source code is freely available and of course linked in the source of this video. The last independent external audit was conducted in 2020 and found no objections to the information officially disclosed by Threema. Moreover, the use of NICI encryption is a simplification of the programming complexity and thus provides easier handling. So all in all, nothing to complain about. Threema is operated by the Threema GmbH in Switzerland. Thus, Threema is subject to both the National Federal Law on Data Protection and the EU General Data Protection Regulation. A privacy policy is also available on the website. However, this is incomplete in one point as it does not have an explanation of cookies. Logically, however, it is impossible to call up a website without sending the server information that the website is to be displayed. Thus, the IP address must be transmitted to the server. This should be visible in the privacy policy, and a cookie box that issues this notice is also part of the GDPR obligations. Thus, Threema can show a small weak point here. Otherwise, there is nothing to complain about, as the excellent privacy by design policy of the developers doesn't collect any personal data and thus cannot be used further. Threema was developed in 2013 by Manuel Kasper as a small side project with his company Kasper Systems GmbH. After initial teething problems resulting from the high demand for security, the app has been operated and sold by Threema GmbH since 2018. In addition to the private version, Threema also offers professional solutions for teams and companies, which are divided into different categories. With its mobile device management, Threema Work is aimed specifically at companies and thus once again clearly differentiates itself from its competitors. The company is certified according to ISO 27100 and thus bears an internationally recognized seal of quality for the security of data processing in its own data center, which is another unique selling point. The app can be purchased with a one-time payment of about 4 euros in the app stores or in the work variants with monthly subscriptions at similar low prices. In conclusion, we can say Threema is truly the most secure messenger you can use right now. If you really care about your privacy, then the price shouldn't be a hurdle. And for convincing your friends, share this video with them. Now, how do you feel after this analysis? Did you learn anything new or is it all old coffee? Drop me your thoughts in the comments and let me know which messenger you use and why. Thanks for your attention and see you next time when we take a closer look at Edward Snowden's messenger of choice. Bye-bye.